It's all about the rain and how you play it.
Oh, you got me this week. I was trying to think of one for like the last 10 minutes. I couldn't think of one. I shot through my chocolate rain and my purple rain ones the last two weeks.
Have been solid. You could throw the chocolate rain one at me anytime you want.
It'll pop you.
Yeah.
Okay, we're back. Heavy rain. It's your boys, Dave Ryan, Mark Robinson.
Howdy. We are blocking out that sweet, harsh sunlight.
Yeah, it's a really sunny day, and as an Irishman, I've missed the heavy rain.
Mm-hmm.
So here we are. We're back again. There's a body on the floor.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, like, in the last...
Oh, you could have hit me with some drowning pool. That would have been a good time.
I don't wish that upon anyone. The last time we played this, your boy here, he was having a pretty rough time.
Because we kept getting him electrocuted.
You kept getting him electrocuted. Oh, Ethan. That is his name, isn't it, Ethan?
Yeah.
Yeah. I have no idea what this broad's name is.
I don't know if she's said it yet. Try Google it if you want.
I could do.
I forgot to throw in the link there.
Yeah, I should do that, shouldn't I?
I dropped him there on his head.
That's no worse than anything else he's had to deal with. Okay. Go on, girl. We got a dual monitor set up going on here.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
How the fuck? Oh, do I have to do it with the right stick?
Uh-huh.
Sorry about this, everyone. This is what happens when I'm not playing for a while. There we go. I forget how to heavy rain.
I mean, I've got WWE Supercard here to keep me entertained, so...
What is it with this sickness of yours?
Look, as I've said before on the podcast, this is why I should never do drugs.
No.
Ethan.
I'm starting to think you shouldn't do games.
Hey, I'm only unemployed for another week and then, you know, back
to
the grind.
For another three, we're going to switch roles fairly quickly.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the only thing that made it all that much worse when I played this before is I was playing it on my iPhone and I could play it anywhere. At least I'm restricted to playing it with a Wi-Fi connection.
Wow, yeah, that's pretty good. That's
he's got a hell of a fever.
Somewhat helpful.
Mm-hmm. He's buzzing. That's what he is.
From all that electrocution.
Are those burn marks on your chest?
Yes. Yes, they are. Lots of them.
Look, mate, I had a hell of a night.
Oi, oi.
Good lord.
I'm going to have to get your clothes off to disinfect those.
Well,
clothes.
Hey.
Oh, hey. They all say that.
Oh, that is a bad time. She is proper casual about this.
I think, like, by sheer accident, pretty much every episode of this we started starts with, like, something really dull and slow.
Yep.
And I keep thinking to myself, why do we keep coming back to this? But then about halfway through, like, shit goes mad again.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, yeah, that's why.
Yeah.
It's a good time.
I will say this for David Cage. Yeah. The pacing of this game, I'm on board with.
Yeah, it's rather cinematic.
Yeah.
As much as it gives you time to breathe in between the crazy stuff.
Arms look really bad.
Good lord.
I need to disinfect your wounds.
What have you been doing, boy?
Well, you saw, running into fences for an hour. Sorry.
Jason.
Jason! Okay, so go back to his incredibly packed medicine cabinet, because I think this is a motel.
So it should be. He's kind of prepared.
He pretty much has one change of clothes and, like, a full medicine cabinet. What a guy.
I'm no doctor, but I'll do what I can.
I forgot how to word.
Let's go disinfectant first, surely.
Yeah, see, it's during these parts that I can really get engrossed in my WWE Supercard and not have to...
Yeah, just leave me.
Well,
thanks.
You
thanks,
know,
man.
I think you've got button pressing down to a T.
Crap. That's disinfectant.
Or maybe
it's
not.
Really good for burns.
Oh. I didn't know she was going with that first.
She said she needs to sort out the burns.
go.
Easy does it. Easy does it.
Your wounds are disinfected.
That's not gonna help.
Okay. So we're going to ointment now, and this is for the chest.
That should ease the pain.
See, this is one of the moments where the choice of music doesn't really fit. You know? Build the tension as I give you painkillers. Have you ever played the game Painkiller before?
Is that the one that has a gun that shoots shurikens and lightning?
That's the one!
Yeah. Yahtzee just said, all you're telling is that it has a gun that shoots shurikens and lightning.
It's quite insane.
Right, so I've given him painkillers. I should give him antibiotics as well, should I? Or just, anti-fever.
Just knock him the fuck out.
I give him anti-fever, because she said he's running a fever.
Really?
So I'm worried now I'm going to kill him with all these pills.
Well, if she doesn't kill him, he's probably going to end up killing himself.
I put the bandages on him now, and if it still gets me to give him more pills, then I'm going to have to.
Oh, Rovi, always having to spoil my fun. I simply said I was entertained by the idea of Sandow in the G1, and he has to go and throw out some facts at me. Jeez.
How dare he?
How dare he?
Gear up, you prick. Man yourself.
It has to be said, at this point, he just looks like a man utterly defeated by life.
Well, in fairness, he's been through some shit.
How do you feel?
How do you feel? Are you prepared to enter
hell? He's rocking that No Mercy 64 style bandaging.
Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up.
Yeah, again, she's very casual about all of this.
I've just seen a man effectively dead on the floor in this motel I'm staying in. Clearly burned from electrocution and wounded. Just give him some pills and a nap and he'll be fine.
He's kind of cute though. And I'm just going to sit here and watch him because that's not creepy at all. Oh look, she's going to fall asleep. Which is, like, ironic because she's an insomniac.
Well, she did say in the last episode coming to the motel helped her sleep.
That's true. Go on, son, you can do it. Go on.
How do you feel?
Words?
I've been better.
There you go.
Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
Because people can be nice.
You didn't really leave me any choice. I couldn't just leave you like that.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I am.
Tell the truth!
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months.
Yeah, everyone in this game has.
The kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but, it's not easy. You got some kind of a problem?
Where shall I start? Or you could just shout, Jason.
Let me show you my
Jason.
Let me show you my shoebox full of crazy shit.
You You mixed up with the mafia? Owe someone money? Something like that?
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Oh, yeah, that was her name.
Right.
Literally no memory of her saying her name is Madison.
Take care.
Try not to, you know, fall in a shark of piranhas.
Yeah, I'll try not to fall in it. A shark full of piranhas sounds pretty awful. Come on.
Words, Mark. Use them.
Fucking hell. Just, I won't sleep tonight anyway thinking of a shark full of piranhas. Or is it like a shark made out of piranhas? It's just like a bunch of piranha.
Oh no.
Have become trained to like form the shape of a shark.
That sounds unpleasant. Yeah, I know where that bit of the game goes next. Okay. And it's not fun.
Thanks, man.
I can't remember. Did you finish this?
No.
Okay.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed
nobody. I didn't do it.
Why did you run away when they came to question you? I already told you. I forgot to report to my parole officer.
What is the guy I really badly chased down the street?
When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
Wow, for...
We checked out his statement.
A world that has future glasses. That is a really, really old-timey camcorder.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother is here. She'd like to speak with you.
Awkward.
It was a few months back, the middle of the night. It was pouring
in the middle of the night.
Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been.
She's starting to point the finger at him.
He spoke about drowning the rain. He didn't make any sense.
Just fucking frame rate is going to garbage.
Something.
He's also really not typing on those keyboards.
Something in his eyes. Has it? There may be no connection, but the next day there was that announcement.
Does it also sound like
about another victim?
Her voice is really low in the mix.
Of the origami killer.
It is a lot, isn't it? I might try and fix it.
Find my son. I'm begging you.
I think it's just that the music has gone real high.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Future glasses, your favorite guy.
I'm Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I'm able to pause right here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's fix that.
Oh, so the mix is even across, so yeah, that's just weird on their part.
So we just got about half?
Yeah.
Beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit
oath. Of secrecy? Could you not have just said, like, doctor-patient confidentiality?
But they're the kish.
He's right. Legally, you gotta tell us what you know.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. Now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate for your own sake.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
What's the attitude on him?
He's starting to move.
Doctor, a child's life is at stake. You may know something that could help us save him.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's
life.
Oh,
Blake.
So, you're going to be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really going to lose my temper.
Blake, that's enough. Let's get out of here.
Let go of me. You have no right.
I think Blake's trying to choke a man, and Future Glasses is just standing there stroking his chin.
Well, yeah, he doesn't want no part of that nonsense. Oh, Blake.
Come on, Doc.
Why are you so angry?
An easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice.
Well, this is a bit.
You have no right to hit him. I'm saving a kid's life for Christ's sake. If you don't like it, leave. If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case.
Yeah.
What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? Were you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me all rights. So you're going to stop this shit right now.
Boy, that's some voice acting straight out of the room.
Some of the phrasing here, you can tell that a man, like, who English isn't his first language,
yeah,
is writing this. Morbid neurosis. It doesn't give me all rights. It's a very strange way to put that sentence.
A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
The plot thickens.
Future Glasses. Hey!
Yeah, something lost. At home as well. Hilarious.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the Origami Killer.
Wow, that's a bit of a bold... This guy fucking sucks!
Yeah.
Fuck me!
There's a reason they don't give him the Future Glasses, I'll tell you that much.
Jeez!
Here's Action Man.
The greatest hero of them all.
The greatest CQC hero of them all.
I'm playing a bit of Top Golf. You don't have Top Golf in Ireland, do you?
It's Top Golf.
I'll tell you, doesn't know. It's like golf, but with pool or snooker.
Not quite enough. It could be a thing.
I'm pretty sure we don't.
Like, I barely know what I did earlier today, so I wouldn't necessarily trust me.
Nice shot.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Yeah, well, the idea is... I should probably let you listen to this.
Do you play?
I tried once, but I think the owner of the course is still looking for me.
It's an interesting sport.
No, it's not.
It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Take off your jacket and grab a club.
Take off your pants and jacket. Hey. A terrible out. Oh, Shelby, you got to do something about that midsection, honestly.
The balls are in that basket.
Is it going to end with someone being clumped over head?
I can't believe I'm going to do quick time golfing.
When you feel ready, you swing.
All of this is still probably better than the Rory McIlroy PGA game.
Oh, shit. I have to do all that for the whole way down all of it.
Hell, it's only your first ball.
Again, it's fair to say this game does give a range of emotions to you.
I'm a assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
I hear you've been asking questions about my son.
That's right. I want to know if Gordy is linked to the Origami Killer case in any way.
There you go.
My son had nothing to do with that sordid case.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
With all due respect, Mr. Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
Also, your son's a bit freaky.
Also.
Do you know what this reminds me of a little bit? Is, you know Sin City? With the mayor.
I'm an influential
and
man.
Rock.
Yeah.
And I pay very well for loyalty.
He's senator, wasn't he? Senator Rock.
Oh, something like that.
Harris Booth.
Yeah. And his son, who was a little bit on the...
Next style, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
I think you misunderstood me. I don't play that game.
Don't go near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
You'll get a golf club around the back of the head.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.
Drops the mic. Gone, gone. Give me the irony where you whack it and it goes nowhere.
Or where Shelby comes back and goes boop just as he's taking the swing. Who are we going to next?
Oh, Jesus.
Here he is.
Sadness himself in human form. Good facial hair, though.
Solid. Why is no one looking into how much rain there is? Like, even here, it stops sometimes.
Oh, dear. I'll be honest, that's the one part of this game that I'm willing to overlook.
Why no one's looking into the rain?
Porcelain lizards? They look new. Out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
Sure, I'll keep hold of it.
Where do you even buy a porcelain lizard?
Oh.
Oh wait, it wants me to try and shatter it, doesn't it?
A porcelain lizard?
Nothing in it?
Well, that's just vandalism. I can't condone this.
I'm assuming there'll be one that has something in it and will hear like a rattle.
Maybe.
Otherwise, this is utterly pointless. There we go.
Oh. What do you got for me? Look at that. You am investigator. You're not going to check all the others? We're not allowing you.
It won't allow me. Oh. Yeah, that was it. I think it was assuming I'd walk the end, seeing there was a lizard on the door. Try and figure it out. One step ahead of you, Cage.
Oh, boy.
Decrepit room with an iPad in the middle.
Yeah, you didn't see what was on the floor, did you? Because I did.
Was it shite?
No.
Some poo on the floor?
No, 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 no.
Was it sadness?
yeah, you could say so.
Was it rain?
No.
Because it's always rain.
It was always rain. It is time to play a game. To save your son? Come on, he's been suffering. 5 minutes to cut off the last section
of one of your fingers in front of the camera. Oh no.
If you succeed, you will get your reward.
No, didn't want to do that. Oh, I see, there's a hatchet. Is that what you saw?
Yeah, there was like an axe on the floor. I think it's fair to say he's probably having a moment.
No, scissors isn't gonna fucking cut it, mate.
Ha, ha, I see what you did there. Oh, you're a funny man.
Do you like that one? That one's for you, buddy. Yeah, a saw would technically do the trick, but I think there's like quicker ways to do it. Like, I would much prefer if it would let me pick up the hatchet. I'd feel a lot better about it, but for some reason it won't right now.
I've suddenly just got the song I Want to Hold Your Hand in my head.
I want to hold your hand.
And cut your finger off.
I won't.
You have 4 minutes.
Oh, Jesus, that was the longest 30 seconds ever.
Oh, here we go. Meat cleaver stuck in the door.
Aye.
That'll fucking do the trick. So I'm thinking for something that could get done in like... Like, the sawing motion, I think, would be much more unpleasant, to be honest. I'd really prefer the hatchet. I think the hatchet has the best shot of being...
I really prefer you just let the kid drown, but, you know, that's just me.
To be honest, I'm getting to that stage as well.
Boy. Boy, there's nothing about this that's fun. Alright, woman.
Oh, I hit pause. Joe's weird, I had to do that in Until Dawn as well.
Really?
Well, I was told to do it. And I didn't, but then I ended up getting my arm chopped off anyway in a bear trap.
Yeah, feel the adrenaline pumping in your...
We should play Until Dawn sometime.
Ah, no, we're grand.
Just get you and Brian to play it together and I'll just sit. Under the desk. Could have looked under the desk the whole time. It just says, sucker! Take the finger widget, still like still reattach it, but on ice.
And you get to watch your son drown. Roosevelt.
Oh, come on. It's surely, like, be able to narrow it down now.
Look, he's got to be absolutely sure. Boy, that was unpleasant.
Is that the bit you knew that was coming?
Yep. And it was as... Because I remember way back when this game first came out, Niner was talking to me about it. And he mentioned that scene in particular and said it was deeply unsettling. And he was correct.
Indeed.
You know, and to be fair, everything he says is deeply unsettling because he's a Tory.
We're in position. Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant. At this point, I'd expect them to actually just nail him in the foot.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What the fuck is that girl doing there? If Mars comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down.
How would she know where he is?
She followed him.
She took her sweet time.
She's going inside. Maybe she lives there. Us just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Again, this seems just very blasé about how she... What's he doing there?
What's he doing?
Wait for a go
there?
On my.
Be Ryan.
Controls that just are based on flicking the controller, you know. I'll take that over fucking. What was that game? I was watching the other day, there was a Giant Bomb stream from a few years ago.
Solid Rigger Pro.
No. But he was.
You should watch that.
Yeah, I have watched that. But he was using the controller to fly a jet around, and he was really over exaggerating his arm movements.
Although, I'll tell you, that's apparently what it's like to control the I-Wing in Star Fox Zero. That's how you have to do it.
Two men at the door, nope. Hold your positions.
Just nope.
You better control the ship that way or the aiming reticle.
There is no fucking way that is happening.
Let's go this way.
I mean, anytime you want to ask why he's severed his finger. Oh. There you go.
State of his knees from, like, everything that's happened.
From life.
Well, generally dragged through broken glass.
Yeah, I remember that. In the last episode. Yeah. Do you know why that happened? Because you was doing it completely wrong.
All right.
Hey, you! Don't move! I'll shoot!
Come on! Quick!
I can't.
Hands in the air!
Shit! Lieutenant, there's a man and a woman exiting the alley.
A woman? Shit! It's that girl who went in! Everybody downstairs! They're in the alley! Follow them!
Okay, across the subway.
Oh look, we're playing Frogger. Do you know what I've apparently just read as well? So, apart from the fact that there is an Angry Birds movie and that's an actual thing,
yeah.
Apparently the Limp Bizkit cover of Behind Blue Eyes is on the album soundtrack.
Huh.
I almost have to see this film now.
So I will say the Odeon sponsored thing for the Angry Birds movie that happens before every film you see in Odeon right now. It's funny.
It's charming. Funny. It's charming.
The bit that slays me is trying to type things in for a remote control. Oh man, the struggle's real. It really is. It's like that moment is just too real.
Ethan, what's the matter?
Well,
gotta keep going.
I'm too weak. Ethan, whenever I walk through crowds, I feel compelled to shout,
oh,
Jason.
Jesus, it is as well, isn't it?
What?
There is that, yeah. God, that bit of the game was just a fucking clown show. Just close your eyes, go to your happy place.
I'm just like snowplowing these people.
I'm now looking again to see if I can see replica models. There you go, going through the right one, jeez.
That shouldn't work.
Hey!
Actually, I don't think that'd turn once for one of them.
Motherfucker!
Ow!
Hey, watch it, man!
Please! Stop or I'll shoot!
And he will.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he even offered you the chance to stop.
Yeah, this is a bad idea. Please don't die. Whoa!
We gotta get on that train, Ethan. It's our only chance.
I love that his response was,
man. Do you know what would really make this game for me?
What?
If on the end credits, you had a birthday!
Shiny, happy.
Well, so far, you've not let anyone die.
We heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the origami killer, Ethan Mars.
Why is he saying origami? Surely, like, with their accent, they should be saying origami.
Well, you know, he says Mario. Well, they say Mario.
And they hope that they will soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
Boy, the graphical texture on his knees is not great.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you liked, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
Policia!
Any cops?
No, I think we lost them. The guy at the desk, though, he gives me the creeps. I don't trust him. You're all over the news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the origami killer. Is it
true?
Are
you?
Are you the killer, Ethan?
Boy, please give the option for yes or no.
I sometimes have these blackouts.
How is this not a yes or no answer, or not a yes or no answer?
I know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies.
What?
The bodies in the water.
Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you in that apartment?
I think my other self is testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I love my son enough to save him. That means there's some part of me that knows where Sean is. But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why
the fuck is this?
And tell them why. That I'm a schizophrenic who drowns his victims and has kidnapped his own son.
I don't think it's him, though.
No, I don't think it's him, but what the fuck is this?
I do believe, I have gotten the sense since early on in the game that he thinks it's him.
Yeah.
When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
Well, I didn't think that's the part he would confide in her with. I think he'd confide in going, my son is the latest victim. Did I fuck kill him?
You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
See, the only thing that's really ruining this for me is her facial expressions are so off kilter and not in sync with what this conversation is.
Yeah, his apart from like his over animated mouth are generally quite good.
Yeah, because his eyes are sad and it's the video game.
Yeah. And it seems like whenever they go for anything but sadness in people's eyes, they just look dead and empty.
Yeah.
Like his wife.
Yeah.
His wife is a fucking monster.
Are
we
on for time,
buddy? Well, we probably got a good another 20 minutes.
Leave me to do this on my own.
I need to do this on my own to prove myself. I'm pretty sure we've had this same conversation at least 3 or 4 times now.
Mm-hmm. Wait, no, I love her. Come back.
You gotta go up.
Moving on up.
I'm moving on up. As a member. Them people, you remember them? They won a Mercury Award.
Really?
Yeah. 1993, I want to say.
What a strange little fact you
have. Yeah, I know, right?
Should I see if I can top up on painkillers or something before I leave?
I can be Jack every now and again.
No, you can't. Often imitated, never replicated. Wow. Well, kind of the show, Jack Lizzo. It's just an open stump. His stump of a finger is not like he's bandaged all around his hand except for the very top where he cut his fucking finger off. You fucking mook.
What mook?
Yeah.
Is that Irish?
No, it's a. I think Jewish people say it.
Really?
Yeah. I've heard it in a bunch of things. It's basically the equivalent of like goon or idiot or something like that. But I like it. Sounds good to say.
Alright.
Try it out.
Huh?
Try it out.
Mook.
Yeah, it's good enough.
Are you prepared to kill someone to save your son?
I've killed my finger. Does that count?
Boy, this is a bad time.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Give him a gun. Well.
I just watch the animation. I watch it on the replay thing. He runs out the door, and then as soon as he goes out the door, he just stops dead for a second. It's great. Let's watch it out. Oh shit.
Game of the year right there.
Come on, future lasses, you can do it.
Jeez.
Fuck this. Turns out, when those appear, you can press them in any order, which is not necessarily the way music works at all.
You've clearly never played a piano before.
Your vodka, sir.
Doesn't really matter what keys you hit.
Thanks.
Or in what order you hit them.
Yeah.
Once you look cool while you're doing it, you the right music will come out.
It's hard to look cool when you have those cunty glasses and that cunty glove on.
With the investigation. I think another episode of Family Guy where Pete figures out when he's drunk and plays like the X-Files theme song perfectly. Yeah.
Not you.
I'll say that fucking theme song is haunting on piano. Though. It's great.
Huh?
The X-Files theme song is haunting on piano.
Oh, yeah.
It just doesn't make sense.
It's a good
show. The psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid. Mars is not the Origami Killer. Let's stake my life on it.
You could have fucking shared that information when you were chasing him.
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Oh,
maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
Is this guy going to be like fucking Grady in The Shining and he's not real?
Yeah, or it's a dog.
Oh, one last thing, sir.
Because this looks very like the bar in The Shining. Indulge in you know what.
It can be dangerous.
I fucking think that's what's happening
very
here.
Dangerous.
I'm trying to keep a handle on
this. This is all gone Twin Peaks.
I'm about 60% certain that they're doing an homage to The Shining here. The gold bar with the piano music.
It'll end up killing
and the creepily overly helpful and familiar.
That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Calling it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what that's supposed to be.
Dave.
Even if he's not actually a ghost in this, I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be an homage.
Dave. What bar is our.
What bar?
Is our waiter.
I believe he's at, given the texture of the hotel around him, I believe he's a classic Whisper Gold rapper.
Oh, nice. I was thinking, just because he looked like he had a sort of velvety suit on, it was a red velvet cupcake.
The video recording.
Johnny Quilby as well.
Yeah.
Bourneville.
Oh.
I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know.
Shout out to OSW Review. It's a great show. So much better than this clown show.
Yeah.
Definitely better edited, by which I mean edited at all.
Well, Chevrolet model corresponding to the time.
Hey, at least put fun now. Custom.
Not just live to stream.
Yeah.
When in the opposite direction at 1637. That could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared. Could it be the killer's car?
Mr. Life on Mars.
Man, there's a lot of lost opportunities here for good music. Any music. I still keep getting getting the Black Holes and Revelations album artwork. Yeah. Isn't that your man who did like all of the Pink Floyd album artwork as well?
What's his name? Oh, please look up his name, that's gonna bug me.
I can do that.
It's some sort of like Scandinavian sounding name.
Black.
Thorson or something like that is.
Artwork Storm Thorgerson.
Storm Thorgerson, that's it, yeah, that's him.
Let's see.
Yeah, that's I know his face.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, because he did the bad Bicky Clare albums as well. Hey, he's born in Hertfordshire.
There you go.
Well, it was Middlesex, now it's Hertfordshire.
So hold that down.
See, I never really figured out about this. So we had a county called Middlesex, which doesn't actually exist anymore.
Strange.
Yeah.
Why does it not exist anymore? Did the ground open up and swallow it all, because I think I would have heard about that.
No, it's mainly because like its location was basically what is now known as like equal parts Greater London and equal parts Hertfordshire. So
let's
they just
see.
Like I think they just kind of cut it in half and said right, that's Greater London, which is part of the Greater Borough of London and Hertfordshire. I think, don't quote me on it. When it comes to me and knowledge of my country, I am limited at best.
I've learned this about you. Oh my god, Devon?
Mass transit?
Jackson Neville.
Wait, no,
AKA
that's Ezekiel Jackson.
Jack.
It is.
Involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles. Considered to be very dangerous.
With John DeAngle, that's it.
This guy might have provided the killer with a car. It's a pretty slim lead, but it's all I have right now.
Future glasses. It is very typical human race that we invent something as cool as these future glasses. Why? So you can bring your desk with you on the go.
Uh-oh, he's on a noseblade.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you know what.
What is going on here?
It can be dangerous. Very
proper
dangerous.
Is a fucking Grady from The Shining thing. I call that.
It's coming.
That was so it's like came. Not a subtle homage. Like I like it because I like the
all
idea of like
I
making an homage to great movie.
And the pain will go away. I should resist.
I like
this
dark face when he's
I know. I can resist. I just need to stay in control and do something until it goes away.
Please don't tell me one of the victim events is masturbate furiously.
Flick. I think this is like
vodka. This will help.
I think this is a like tower defense, but like to prevent you going towards the what the fuck is Tractica? Drink that vodka.
Well, that's undone all the good work of vodka.
Boy, he's looking like he's having a bad time. Stay away from the tryptocaine. Flick. Oh no. Yeah. H2O.
I want to see what happens. Because last time I snapped and I took it like really quickly. I was just getting fed up.
Well, I imagine, because I do know one of the things about this game is that there is the possibility that people can die. Oh! So, like, I presume he would die.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Well, then I've done remarkably well to keep everyone...
I was going
to
say.
I'm off being operated or something. There actually is no genuine, like, game-changing...
You can finish this game. Like, depending on how you play it, there are multiple different endings.
Huh. Is it still always the same killer?
I think so. I think it's more to do with, like, just what the ending of the game is and whether the Origami Killer gets away with it or blah, blah, blah. Because, again, shout out to my friend Nino, but, like, he has played this game and he had his one ending and he never went back to it. Because I can't imagine anyone playing this game more than twice at best.
Unless you were like really committed to getting a platinum.
I don't know if that's in the trophy awards, but like,
I imagine you'd have to play it every permutation.
I really fucking hope not.
That's what these games usually do.
This
is real trippy. I like it.
Yeah, but like, I got it in the 90s when you had a game like Silent Hill where it gave you multiple endings where you'd have to...
Silent Hill 2 has, I think, 5 endings?
Yeah.
Definitely 5, maybe 6.
Yeah.
Hello, anyone here?
In this day and age...
Same fucking room.
Okay. In this day and age, YouTube.
Well, that's what I mean. Like, I think only achievement hunters. I think, like, there's one thing to be said, like, right, okay, yeah, if you're curious enough, do a YouTube on it.
Yeah.
Take a shower.
Look, I'm enjoying this scene for what it's worth. It's going on for a while.
Yeah. I like it, though. It's not your state of fuck. Well, you see, the thing I'm playing it, and you're only passively watching it.
Drugs are bad.
That helps things for a while. Oh, here we go. I think part of what made it drag on for so long was I didn't think of the shower straight away. This seems to be helping. I mean, you could have taken your gear off, mate. Like, it's clear that everybody only owns one set of clothes in this game, so
yeah.
I want to drench them. It's going to catch his death of cold. Huh.
You got a trophy?
That chapter was called Ludwig von.
Huh.
It's a bit Beethoven. Maybe a little subtle Clockwork Orange reference.
There. Maybe. What was the...
Do you know what I've noticed one of the updates has done to streams? Have a look at the screen there. If you get a trophy, it fuzzes out your information.
Ah! How about that?
Yeah, I think it's starting to hide usernames and stuff.
Manfred!
I'm sorry, who the fuck is called Manfred in the
21st
century?
I was just
going to
say, that is fantastic. That is real, like David Cage going, we've kind of run out of names. Let's look at the oldie book of stupid names. Manfred. Apologies to any Manfreds on the stream.
Hi there, Manfred.
Who is it?
Scott. Scott Shelby.
Do you want to see a solid suicide dive?
Go on.
Scott? It's Scott! Oh! Yes,
that may nearly have resulted in a suicide.
Yeah.
How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
Oh, at my age, time means nothing anymore. I repair clocks, but I try to forget about time.
Oh,
irony.
Oh, my word.
Are you still with the police?
No, but I'm with the irony police.
He looks like that guy who plays the barman at Tourette's and Doc Science. Have you seen Moon Accents?
No.
It's like the best B movie ever.
No, we had this conversation because Broforce has the
Tones in it. Yeah, we should definitely watch that someday.
Yeah.
Sorry. If you enjoy Willem Dafoe chewing scenery, this may be him at his absolute peak. Like, this is his equivalent of Nick Cage at the end of The Wicker Man.
Could I not just watch Beyond Two Souls or play Beyond Two Souls? Or, nah, to be fair, is watch Beyond Two Souls.
You mean, could I not just watch me play it? Is that what you mean?
I don't know if I want to do another David Cage game. Not for this lifetime, anyway. Scott,
tell them to
call
back this afternoon. Tell them to fuck off.
Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Well, to old friends.
The gnash is on you, man.
Chin Chin?
Gambe. See, now here's the difference between English and Chinese culture. In England, you just say cheers and you have a little drink. Gambe, you have to down the drink. And it's usually like a full fucking shot of this like 60% rice wine.
Beautiful. Oh, that's...
It's a Stradelli.
Awesome. Is that the wife?
Crafted in Venice in the 18th
the
century.
Eden's wife.
Who, her?
It's one of my favourite
No, that's the bird who the... Who, like when you did the first... The guy you did the first... Scott.
Oh, he's your one that gave him the letter. I'd like you to have a look at the stuff that she found.
Yeah.
I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Three main women in this don't look dissimilar enough for me to not confuse that half the time.
I will not dispute it, but I would disagree with you. Magnifying glass
from behind the counter.
Sure, and City are winning.
My eyes are beginning to.
That's bad for us.
Yes.
I would appreciate it if they weren't.
7 minutes into the game as well. And your man Aguero.
Of course it is. But at least it's my fantasy team that I don't care about. I'm the best win in the world every season I start the fantasy football. But I forget about it really quickly.
No, 1-1.
Hey!
I feel like we're missing quite a game here. Olivier Giroud. The man with the most beautiful hair in all of football, it must be said.
Indeed.
Like, if you have a counter-argument, I'm all ears, but I'm still going to disagree.
Thanks.
Andre appeared on.
Do you know who has an absolute fucking appalling haircut? It's Sergio Aguero.
Royal Five.
What is your man doing?
Yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model.
He's a handwriting expert as
produced
well?
Between 1907 and 1924.
Oh, it's typewriting.
Yeah. No doubt about it. It's a Royal Five.
These typewriters, are they rare?
No, they're fairly common. I'd say many folks have one gathering dust in an attic or in their cellar.
Are there many places around that could repair one of these?
I bought the company's entire stock of spare parts for a song in 64. Well, they were going to take them to the dumpster, so I got the lot. Well, anybody around here who has one that actually works has been to see me at one time or another.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Man, what life this guy
really
leads.
Help us out.
Jeez.
Delighted to help.
Fucking party animal over here.
And I'll be right back with the list.
This is going to be your last scene, by the way.
You think the killer's been here?
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list.
That was a weird scene.
It was, wasn't it?
There are some nice touches.
Hello? Your call is locked, sir. A police car will be there in a few minutes.
What the fuck?
Sir? Hello?
God, he's dead. Oh, God.
You know, whatever I was going to say, it doesn't really matter now.
Scott? Oh, my God.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police.
The killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We got to get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. We better work fast. The police are going to be here any minute.
I have to remember everything I touched.
Lauren, did you touch anything?
Did I touch you?
Do you want to ask her whatever?
I think that's to, like, when we're ready to go. I don't think I touched both of these shot glasses. Or the bottle. Definitely just a magnifying glass.
Do you want to pause it and I can have a look for you?
What
to see everything that you touched?
I'll just
wing it.
Yeah. I definitely touched the phone over beyond as well. And she touched the ballerina. Front of the shop. Obviously.
Yeah.
There's not much over here.
Scott, are you going to be much longer? The police will be here any second.
I'm almost finished.
I'm pretty sure I am finished.
That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
Yes. Did you clean up her?
Yeah.
Yep.
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. Come on, let's go.
Fuck.
What?
That didn't... Fuck. The phone.
Did you...
The last phone. I forgot about the phone. Fuck.
So...
Oh, well.
You claim the victim was killed while you were in his shop.
Yes, he went to get something in his office. A few minutes later, I went in to see if he was okay. That's when I found him.
You should have called the police immediately, Mr. Shelby. Would have saved us dragging your ass down here.
Listen, we had nothing to do with his murder. We were only there by coincidence. I just wanted to spare myself a few hours declaring I didn't see anything to a police officer.
P.I. or not, Mr. Shelby, don't leave town. And if you end up next door to any more dead bodies, remember to call us. Okay?
Well, that could have been a lot worse.
Well, boy. Well, Scott Shelby.
Next time we end up next to a dead body, I'm not fucking using you to clean up my tracks.
I'm in the wrong place. You know what it's like.
And again, like, you've turned the music down, I still feel like the voices are very low in the mix.
For old times.
Unless it reverses.
Thanks, Carl. I owe you one.
You on to anything at the moment?
Nope.
Really weird. Unless it doesn't count the.
Well, I got some ideas.
No,
it's just the in game. Because, in fairness, when I'm actually playing, I can't hear the music anymore.
Yeah.
Really.
Tell me about it, you Scott.
So we call this stim that cuts in the.
Yeah. Here's a question for you. How does a private investigator get funded?
Hooking.
Eh?
Turning tricks.
Where are you going?
All right.
Taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners, remember? We had a deal.
Well, don't they get paid like in the movies? We'll call this an end, by the way. In the movies, they usually get paid like half up front. Of their fee to go and find the person or something like that, and then they get paid the other half upon completion of the investigation.
Dunno.
Right, that was Heavy Rain.
Yeah.
For another week.
Yeah.
Good times.
Good times. At Lintercast on Twitter, here, on Twitch, on Facebook, Lintercast, WordPress.com. What is the. I can never remember the.
Linkthecast.wordpress.com.
That's the one. Yeah. Stick around. We are going to play some Dark Souls.
Dim Souls, episode 2. Coming up in moments
Dark
if you're
Souls.
Watching this live.
Dark Harder.
If you're not watching this live, it's already archived. So have a look.
Yeah. All right.
It's your boys signing out.
Peace.